guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. I'm Tanushree and I make videos on beauty, fashion, lifestyle and much more. So if you're new to this channel, welcome and please do not forget to subscribe. Hit that bell icon so that whenever I upload a video, you get notified. Making videos for YouTube. I've been quite busy and my life has completely changed, and it's like the last few months I was rushing from one thing to the other. It was really hectic for me, physically, mentally, overwhelming and so on and so forth. So here I am with today's topic, and as you guys have noticed from the title that it is a bit different one. Not so different one, because I guess if you watched my first vlog on the first vlog is about IIT itself. So many people have requested me, have asked me a lot of questions which was really not possible to answer in that question and answer video which I have also made on that first vlog. So I thought that I'll make a separate video on this topic where people who haven't even watched that vlog will be benefited, and a lot of even my juniors ask me regarding what I have done, how to get there, whatnot. So I'll just bump that. Let's just clear all the confusion in this video itself, and I guess that this video will be super informative for a lot of people who are GATE aspirants. Or I'll be talking about a lot of points in this video, and if I miss any point in this video, I'll make sure that I'll make another video to cover those points. So without further ado, let's just move straight to the video. I won't make this video very informative with all those bullet points and everything. I'll keep it super chatty because that's how you will be able to relate with me as well. And so I have divided this video into small parts, like small sections, where I'll be telling you what you have to do and what I did when I had to do that thing. So the first point will be to have a strategy. Strategies are really confusing, to be honest. If you're preparing for any entrance, every entrance has their own distinct strategy. So, but the basic outline is the same. You have to have a very clear idea of what the GATE exam is. So as you all know that the full form is the graduate aptitude test for engineers, but it's not only for engineers, like the master students, like MSc students can also sit for GATE exams. Coming to the exam pattern, the pattern has, I mean you all know it's a multiple choice questions, and you will have 65 questions in the 3 hours time. So there are three sections. One section is for general aptitude and maths. Then you have one mark MCQ questions. Then you have 2 marks MCQ questions and AMT type questions as well. So you have to be clear about that 65 questions demarcation. And what I mean by that, and what I mean to link with that, is with a strategy. The aptitude questions as well as the maths questions, the first section A, can actually be very important when while determining your rank. But so you have to be very strategic when you are starting from the beginning. Take some time to understand the question pattern even before beginning to study, because I remember what I did in that case when I was in my just fourth semester beginning. Knowing the pattern of GATE much before the starting, so that it kind of give me an idea regarding what strategies I have to make. So in the third, after the third semester, and in the before the beginning of fourth semester, since I was very clear what I wanted to do, I actually studied what the GATE exam is all about, what the first is all about, what sort of questions are there, how people have prepared, because really matters when you are preparing for an all India entrance examination. Like, what is this exam all about, what sort of questions it has, and where the weightage lies, and how, what are my weaknesses and strengths, what are the core topics, from where they ask questions. So these are really, really important, and you really need to have a very clear idea when you are preparing for an entrance examination. And knowing the exam well helps you with the strategy part. So I would like to reframe my first point. So the first point would be know your exam pattern well and then prepare the strategy. So moving forward to the next point would be start early. this is very important. And in whichever entrance you will see, they all ask you to start early. The reason for this is that no matter, even if you start studying early, you'll still be lacking in some subjects, you'll still be lacking in some concepts, and this is like never ending in whichever exam you sit for. But for GATE exam, I would say ki, by starting early, I mean you really need to be very well versed for your semesters. And suppose you are in 4th sem, suppose or 5th sem, whatever it is. So there are certain subjects, right, which we have to study in each semesters. Study those subjects really well. Know that subject in and out. Whatever your college is teaching, whatever notes you are getting, whatever books you are getting, just build up your knowledge. Build up your knowledge. That will help a lot. Because you know what? If you are not well versed in your semesters, you will lack in your concepts, and those, and in the last moment, you won't ever be able to build that concepts. So it's like, suppose I'm studying RDNA, or suppose I'm studying bioprocess. Once, suppose I'm done with the subject, I've prepared for my semesters, then what you need to do is find previous year's GATE question papers. Look for the questions which have been asked from that subject. So once you're done with the concepts, once you're prepared for the semesters, pick a question paper, look for the MCQs from that subject, solve those questions. Trust me, you will make mistakes. There will be some concepts which you will be like coming across for the first time, even after preparing for your semester. So this is like a loop. So you just have to get the knack of it, the habit of it. So if you start early, so like from the third semester onwards, like, and trust me, that helped me a lot when I was actually practicing MCQs, because there were so many topics which I didn't know of. Though I did very well in my semesters, but still there were certain things lacking. But it was very easy to build that bridge. Start, I would suggest, from third or fourth semester onwards, you should definitely start preparing. You should have all your basics clear, at least all the subjects which you're learning at that point. Have your basics clear. There's no need to rush. Just make sure whatever you have studied before or the past 2 years, you are very well versed with that. So that part is done. You just need to practice regarding that part, and you just need to build a lot more concepts regarding different papers and subjects as well. But practice as many questions and just make your concepts very clear. This leads me to the next part, which is regarding the conducting institution. So as you all know that the GATE is being conducted by different IITs every year. So in my case, in 2019, when I sat for GATE, that year the GATE was conducted by IIT Madras. That actually gives you an idea which areas or which topics you need to focus more on. IIT Madras has a very strong research areas in bioprocess, bioseparation, industrial fermentation. So I know that these are the topics which are very, very essential for me if I really want to crack it. So once you get the idea how the institution is, or what the research areas of the institution is, you actually know which areas to put focus into, because I have noticed in a lot of cases that this actually matters. So just have some idea about the research areas of that institute. You have to study everything, but that kind of becomes the most important part for your entrance examination, because in 2019 the entire paper was based on bioprocess. You know, that actually gave a lot of people like who sat for the exam the benefits of cracking it, because they already did the research very well. So this is also like kind of a strategy. So moving to the next part would be how to study. Now this is a very subjective and tricky concept, because this is it depends on the individual. My way of learning and someone else's way of learning won't be the same. For that, I would suggest you or recommend you to find one or two of your friends who are as equal as you are, like work-wise or intellect-wise. It might sound very wrong, but it is very practical when you are dealing with an entrance examination. Because in my case, I had my very good friend at that point, because we used to, you know, discuss the questions, we used to discuss the concepts, and if she's lacking somewhere, I would say, if I'm lacking somewhere, she would also tell me. So that actually helped us both in cracking GATE examination. She also cracked the examination, and me too. So we can kind of come into a common discussion and clear the concepts. That second thing which you need to do is a must is to make notes. I had a single individual copy for each and every semester subjects, and that copy was kept separately for that topic. And whenever I used to study or practice MCQs, or if I used to come certain thing, certain portions, or if I'm reading some books and I'm coming to certain concepts, I used to write in that copy itself. Once I'm done, so suppose I have made a copy for immunology. I have had all the notes from my college for my semesters, and then suppose I read the QB's book and I had that concepts clear, or I read some YouTube video, I saw some YouTube videos, and or suppose you are practicing question papers and you came to some concepts which were not there before. So I used to write in that copy, so my immunology copy is ready. Now what I used to do is, once I'm done with the entire topic and I have kind of studied everything whatever was there, so then I used to do is, I used to write very little notes, and the little notes is like, I used to write the entire immunology concepts in that single 2 sheet ka note. I used to write that entire that copy notes in those 2 pages. So those 2 pages, so suppose you have 18 topics, so you have 18 into 2 chotu pages for that concept. What it does is that since GATE is usually scheduled somewhere around February, so during the December onwards, when you are very stressed out, you won't be having time. Trust me, you won't be having time during December and January to read the concepts, everything. But those 2 pages seems very easy and very breezy as well for a student to go through it, brush up all the concepts very clearly. So I used to write the key words, the key points. Suppose I'm studying about MHC class 2 molecules, I would used to write about that, or APCs, or I would just used to draw arrows and just bullet points them, and that's how I used to make notes. Once I'm done with that, in January, what I did, those 2 pages now reduced to this chotu page kind of a thing. So those 18 pages, what you need to do is to just go through those entire concepts in January so that you are ready for February. That's how I did it. Just be confident. Just know what you are studying. Just be confident in your topics. If you are studying something, be confident. Also, I forgot to tell you, there are certain sites like Swayam, MOOC, NPTEL. I did a lot of courses from NPTEL regarding my subjects. That helped me a lot. Honestly, that helped me a lot. It's not something I'm promoting or anything. But so this was it. I know this was a really, really long video. But if you have made to this point of the video, I am extremely happy for you. And I'm extremely happy for me because you have listened to my non-stop thing for these many minutes. So this was it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. So if you have liked my video, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Hit that bell icon so that whenever I upload a video, you get notified. So I'm ending this video on a good note. And so people who are GATE aspirants for 2022, all the best to you guys. I know you guys would rock it. And if you have any doubts, any queries, please feel free to write in the comment section down below. I would answer the questions as much as possible, as much as feasible. And if required, I would make another video. So just don't worry. Just, you know, rock it and have fun. Bye bye. I'll see you guys in my next video. Take care. Stay safe. Bye.